Hi, good morning students. In this video, there are 65 bits with answers from reproduction 6th chapter of 10th biology. It helps you easy and quick revision. Also solve with suitable diagrams for easy understanding and long memory. These bits belongs to asexual reproductive methods in different organisms and sexual reproduction in plants. Remaining bits are in second part, that means second video. Which life process is necessary for perpetuation and continuation of life? Reproduction. Reproduction is of two types in view of fusion of gametes. What are they? Sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. In which type of reproduction, only half of each parent's chromosomes are passed to the next generation? Sexual reproduction. Name the different modes of asexual reproduction. Fission, budding, fragmentation, parthenogenesis, regeneration, sporulation, and propagation. The organism which reproduces through conjugation is paramecium. Single cell organisms can reproduce by splitting into two or more is called fission. Splitting into two, binary fission. Splitting into more, multiple fission. Binary fission is seen in paramecium, bacteria, etc. Give examples for multiple fission. Amoeba. Give example for budding. Yeast. Fragmentation is a common mode of asexual reproduction in flatworm, algae, fungi, and lichens. The process of development of young ones from unfertilized ovum is called parthenogenesis. Usually, parthenogenesis is seen in wasps, bees, ants, etc. We are able to develop seedless fruits like watermelon, grapes through the process of parthenogenesis. The ability to give rise to new individual organisms from their body parts is called regeneration. Regeneration occurs in planaria. Give an example for vegetative propagative method through leaves. బ్రయోఫిల్లం. గివ్ ఎన్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఫార్ వెజిటేటివ్ ప్రాపగేటివ్ మెథడ్ త్రూ స్టోరెన్. జాస్మిన్ అండ్ స్ట్రాబెరీ. Give an example for vegetative propagative method through bulbs. Onion. Give an example for vegetative propagative method through corns. Colocasia. Give an example for vegetative propagative method through tuber. Potato. Give an example for vegetative propagative method through root. Dahlia, carrot, radish, etc. What are the artificial propagative methods? Cutting, layering, and grafting. Name the plants that propagate through cutting. Rose, hibiscus, etc. Name the plant that propagate through layering. Nerium. Name the plants that propagate through grafting. Mango, citrus, apple, rose, etc. Which technique is very useful in propagating improved varieties of plants with various flowers and fruits? Grafting. In grafting, two plants are joined together. One which is attached to soil is called stalk. In grafting, two plants are joined together. One which is without roots and attached to the stalk is called scion. Which organisms reproduce through sporulation? Fungi like Rhizopus, Mucor, etc. Some non-flowering plants like mosses, ferns, etc. and few bacteria. In fern, leaves produce spores. These leaves are called sporophyll. Which is the sexual reproductive part of the plant? Flower. How many species of flowering plants are there in the world? 2,75,000. Floral structures arise on a swollen part of pedicel is known as thalamus. Name the part that arranged as first wall of the flower. Calyx. Second wall of the flower is corolla. Third wall of the flower is andrecium. Fourth wall of the flower is gynecium. What are the parts of the stamen? Anther and filament. What are the parts of pistil? Stigma, style and ovary. What are the male gametes of the flower and where does they produce? Pollen grains are male gametes of the flower and they produced in the anther. What are the female gametes of the flower and where does they produce? Ovules are the female gametes of the flower and they produce in the ovary. Which is the male reproductive part of the flower? Andrecium. Which is the female reproductive part of the flower? Gynecium. Some flowers have either stamens or carpel. These are called unisexual flowers. Some flowers have both stamens and carpel. These are called bisexual flowers. Give examples for unisexual flowers. Papaya, bottle gourd, etc. Give examples for bisexual flowers. Datura, hibiscus, etc. The transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma is called pollination. The transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma of the same flower is called self-pollination. The transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma of another flower is called cross-pollination. Give an example for self-pollination. Pea plant. At the center of each ovule, there is a microscopic sac-like structure called embryo sac. The embryo sac is composed of gametophyte cells. How many cells are there in embryo sac? What are they? In the embryo sac, there are 7 cells arranged in 3 groups. They are antipodal cells, secondary nucleus, eggshell, and synergids. In embryo sac, all cells are in haploid state except one, which is that? Secondary nucleus. Name the nuclei present in the secondary nucleus. Polar nuclei. How many male nuclei released into the embryo sac through pollen tube? 2 male nuclei enter into the embryo sac for double fertilization. Write the process of double fertilization in plants in the form of equations. First fertilization. Male nucleus plus egg gives rise to zygote. Second fertilization. Male nucleus plus secondary nucleus gives rise to endospermal nucleus. Double fertilization occurs only in flowering plants. Name the part in which pollen tube enters into the embryo sac. Micropyle. The parts of the flower useful even after fertilization are ovary and ovules. Give examples for endospermic seeds. Corn, rice, wheat, castor, etc. Give examples for non-endospermic seeds. Bean, pea, Bengal gram, etc. Endospermic nucleus is in dash state. Triploid state. The most essential floral organs required for sexual reproduction are andrecium and gynecium. Okay, children, study well, grow well, be a good citizen. And proud to be an Indian. Thank you.